respected dignitaries on the dais, Rameshwar, Bhikshmata Ranjay Garu, Jambul Reddy Garu, and all the respected engineers. Many of you are very seniors to me and have been working for the Institution of Engineers. A good evening to all, and my respects to all the great engineers. And I take this as an opportunity to present myself before you today. I am Surya Prakash Ponnada. I have done my post-graduation Master of Science by Research in IIT Madras, 1990 passed out, and I did my Bachelor of Technology in JNTU Kakinada, College of Engineering, in 1986. I started this consulting firm after working for 5 years in Chennai and Hyderabad as a design engineer. In 1994, I founded Satyavani Projects and Consultants. So it's my silver jubilee year of the company, and we have employed about 150 engineers working in our company, and we had the opportunity to work on various types of projects. In the process, I am also a hardcore civil engineer. I would call myself a fundamentalist in civil engineering. So I held the position of President of Association of Consulting Civil Engineers, Bangalore headquarters, and I am also founding President of Pre-Engineered Structures Society of India since 2013, and I also founded a trust called Smart Infrast, that is basically to help civil engineers being good civil engineers. That is the objective, and help students have employability and employment. So with this motto, I started this. In fact, this lecture is one of the 56 lectures I give to the students to motivate them. This is the last lecture actually in the series. So I have chosen this topic when Rameshwar asked me. I thought when it is an endowment lecture, definitely I will be talking about some great engineers. And we are all here to get ourselves inspired and emulate such great engineers. And definitely any engineer, I'm very happy today to learn about the 18 endowment lectures of Institution of Engineers. It's really heartening to note that we have so many galaxy of engineers working for the development of our nation and our states. And today I'm happy that I am part of this endowment lecture. In fact, I gave an endowment lecture for A. Ramakrishna also. I am also trained by Engineer Purushottam Garu, whose endowment lecture is there. I had the opportunity to interact with Ramakrishna Garu. So I would like to learn from all these great engineers. And in the process, I also want to share some of my thoughts that occur to me. And this topic is one of such thing. In fact, we all know, this thought came to me when I started interacting with students of civil engineering. So when I interact with the students, when I take class, to my utter surprise, nobody is interested to listen to the lecture. I'm sure most of the teachers, whoever is here, can see that. I don't get angry against these students because we have to train them. So I went into deep into understanding the reason for that. In India today, we are suffering deep resentment from everybody to every rule. One of such is traffic rule we see. When we have a red signal, we see many people crossing the signal when there is no traffic. I had an opportunity to meet a Japanese delegation who came to India. They said they went outside to see India. First time they came in Taj Krishna, near the signal, they were standing, it seems. Until 8 o'clock, nobody is following the rule. And suddenly at 8 o'clock, they asked us, what is this phenomena? Why suddenly at 8 o'clock, everybody started following rule? we said the traffic police would have come then. So do you need a traffic police to follow traffic rule? Is it not for your safety? So this is the attitude we are passing through. Students don't want to listen to the lecturer, and lecturer doesn't want to teach to the students. This is the fate. This is where the first ethic we have to imbibe among students, that students have to be students, teachers have to be teachers. So this is one thing. And another thing, I had the opportunity to read the book by CVC N. Vittal, Chief Vigilance Commissioner. He wrote that we think that 100% of government employees are corrupt. He says that is wrong. He says that only 5% of positions offer opportunity to be corrupt, and there are only 5% of people who are corrupt and they occupy those positions. And unfortunately, entire citizens interact with that 5% and we think it is 100%. So he says that it's not 100% corrupt, so we are fortunate. So he asks one question. Before you say anybody is corrupt, ask yourself, how many times when you go to fill your fuel in your bike or car in a petrol station by paying cash, insist on a tax bill? And how many times you have insisted on a bill, tax bill from a medical shop? If you follow, and how many times you crossed signal when it is red, when there is no traffic? If you ask these three questions and try to follow, you are also not correct. You are perfect actually. Similarly, how many taxes we are paying sincerely? I mean, nobody is knowing, it is so complex, but are we sincere to ourselves to pay taxes to our country? So these are the things to start with in the ethics. And now I will come to the engineering part of ethics. We see a lot of buildings in distress. I have a lecture on distressed buildings also. I mean, we go in Hyderabad anywhere, we see almost every building having cracks or having damp patches or having corrosion. This is a common scene. Either they are not designed or either they are not engineered. I'm sure no building will be in distress if it is designed. And I always put a challenge to the students that please come up with